I didn't have planned to ask about this, but they just were on the camera. I've noticed you've become pretty heavily tattooed over the last year.
Yeah.
And I see the pictures and it's just like, oh, Finn's got this really random dinosaur tattoo. Tell me about some of them. What's taking you down this path?
Yeah, I don't know. It was always something like I was super curious about. In school, I was super artistic. I almost went to art college instead of becoming a wrestler. And it was all like, I was very heavily like inspired my whole life by art. And I would always look at guys with tattoos and go, wow, that's so cool. But I had kind of the mindset of, I'm so wishy-washy and I change my mind so often that I don't want to commit to anything or I can't commit to anything. And I think, you know, getting a little bit older and a little bit like more carefree, I thought, who cares? It's just a tattoo. It's just skin. Like skin doesn't last forever. I'm going to die anyway. So I'm like, you know, it'll die with me. So, I got this one on my hand. I don't know if you can see, it's like me holding a space helmet, like looking at the moon, kind of idea of following your dreams. I got this dinosaur that my wife drew, this seagull that represents my hometown, because I'm like from a small like little fishing village in Ireland, and a couple other bits and pieces, dates and things like that. I got my wife's name on my hand here. I think
there you go. Yeah,
that was the one that like opened the floodgates, you know.
Yeah,
I like.
well, you went. Yeah, you wasted no time. When I used to work in the tattoo shop, anything on your hands or your neck, they called job stoppers. if you had a tattoo on your hands or your neck, you better know what you're doing with your career. I'd say you're safe. I mean, you've done pretty well, but yeah, you just went right for it.
Yeah, I had like a lot of plans to like accelerate the amount of tattoos I was getting, and then like with lockdown and quarantine, a lot of the artists I want to work with are like, you know, outside of Florida, so I haven't been able to travel. But I think once the world gets a little bit back to normal, I'll up the ante a little bit.
Amen.
There's an artist outside of Florida that I heard used to be pretty good at tattoos. He's probably in Pittsburgh right now. You might be talking to him. Would you ever let Graves tattoo something on your body?
Absolutely.
Don't answer it, Graves. That's not a question for
well,
you.
Well, I'm going to cut you off, Vic, because no. I never actually did tattoos. I was
Don't
a weird
tell
guy.
Him that. Just let me get the answer out. I think this is a great spot. We can put it on social media. Graves tattoos Finn Bálor.
Graves, regardless of if you've done tattoos or not in the past, I would be open and willing to let you tattoo me.
That is the nicest thing anybody's ever said to me.
I wouldn't let you come near me with a needle. Absolutely not. You're a brave man, Finn. You are a brave man.
So, Finn, talk to us a little bit more. You're talking about the art that inspires you. This is a side that I don't think people get to explore very much. Where do you draw your inspiration from? Obviously, with all the body paint and throughout your career, you've shown glimpses of that. Where do you draw inspiration from?
Everywhere, man. Comic books, movies, TV shows, like looking out the window at a tree I can draw inspiration from, just anything. If you can, like, I feel like so many wrestlers like get so like tunnel vision and focused on like what's happening in wrestling. We're just like replicating what's happening in wrestling, where there's so many more things, you know, in the world that are like so incredibly beautiful that like, you know, we can draw inspiration from. And, you know, whether it's, you know, looking at a lake, or whether it's, you know, walking down a street in New York City and like seeing some trash on the street and going, oh, that looks cool. You know, like you can always be inspired.
Oh my God, it's the demon and he's dressed like a trash bin.
Duke the dumpster drossy.
No, but I appreciate that outlook, man. That's something I think we all could be better at, is to take a minute and sort of just be present and acknowledge all the beauty around us. Sorry, I got deep, Vic.
Vic, hold on. Hold on. You're not going to railroad me right now. Did you guys just have a moment?
We did. We did have a moment. And you were excluded because you don't like nice things. Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Apple Podcasts. Subscribe now and never miss an episode.